Hi, and welcome to the second part of this mini-series, where we are creating a super simple character controller in Unity. If you haven't already, go check out the first part to get you all set up with Unity's new input system. In this episode, we will be making our character move with the WASD keys. So, what I've gone ahead and created is just a simple level with a floor and some walls. You can quickly create a floor by adding a cube or a plane and making it roughly 20 by 20 in size on the X and the Z axis. Select your character object and attach a character controller component to it by clicking on the Add Component button and searching for Character Controller. You could, of course, create a character controller with a rigid body and some physics, but if you're just starting out your game, I don't see the need for that. You'll get a lot done with the built-in character controller. And we can just ignore these values for now. Now that we have a character controller component, we can go ahead and open up our player controller script again. Let's start with creating a private variable for our character controller. You can simply call it character controller. Add an awake method and let's look for a character controller. Character controller equals, and we need to get the component with getComponent, and within angle brackets, type character controller. Don't forget the opening and closing parentheses. This would now, of course, cause errors in case we didn't add the character controller component to our player object, or if we accidentally were to remove it. If you want to make sure there is one, you could up here, right above public class player controller, type require component in square brackets, then type off in parentheses, and finally character controller. Like that. If we try to remove the character controller component from our player object now, we'll get a warning telling us that the player controller script is dependent on it. Next, we will create a private variable of type vector3 and call it direction, which will take care of the direction we're moving in. Let's also add a serialized variable of type float and call it speed, which will simply control the speed of our character. In our move method, we can now remove the debug log and take the input value and use it to set our newly created direction variable. Direction equals new vector3, input.x, 0 on the y-axis, and remember that we are working with vector2 values here, so we will put the y value from said vector2 into the z-axis. So, instead of moving on the y-axis when pressing W or S, we will now be moving on the z-axis. Let's now add an update method where we will be doing the actual moving of the character. Moving your character is actually very simple. Reference the character controller, followed by .move. If you look at the documentation, you'll see that the move method requires a vector3, which in our case is the direction variable, so let's type that in. If you try to run this, it should work, but maybe not as you'd expect. Your character will be moving very, very fast. So let's first change the speed. I'll just set mine to 5. Back in our player controller script, in the update method, we can multiply our direction variable by our speed variable in the move method. Now, let's also multiply it by time.deltaTime to make the movement frame rate independent. Let's jump back into Unity and try this out. And there you have it! Your character should now be moving around on your level using the WASD keys. Now that we have our basic movement done, we will start looking into rotation, applying gravity, jumping, and camera rotation. All this and more coming up. As usual, you will find this project on GitHub with a link in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.